Go on. Thank you all for joining us. Why do this record?
What drives us is we really want to make a difference. And Michael Jackson was the perfect artist who spoke to all of us. He tapped us on the shoulder and said, would you just do me one small favor and remind people that I'm the greatest? And we all said yes. And that's why this album.
LA, how did this project start?
So the project started with a conversation that I had with John Branca. How about you let me hear everything that's been recorded, everything on tape, whether it's an entire song or a fragment of a song, let me hear everything. And then let me go out and put my team together and make an album on Michael.
I want to ask you all what Michael meant to you on a personal and professional level. Tim, you're the lead producer on this, so I want to start with you on this question.
Michael was one of the greatest entertainers. I felt like I had to dig into a place where it's just deeper than just music. Mm-hmm. I have to dig into a place to where he would accept what I'm doing without him telling me this is right.
You know, sometimes you don't know exactly why you end up where you end up. It's not always in your plans, you know? And so something spoke to me in the last year that said, you know, you should do something really special with Michael. And that special project ended up being Xscape.
When L.A. called me to be part of the project, at first I was a little hesitant. And it wasn't that I didn't trust L.A. It's just that I worked with Michael before. And I knew what his expectations was, what his standards were.
The very first thought was, I love Michael Jackson. I would love to be involved. But then there was also some reservation because, I mean, are the songs going to be any good? Is it just going to be some material that's kind of half finished?
Once L.A. played me the music, I was all the way in. I was like, oh, yeah, this is a Michael Jackson. This is one of them classic albums.
I heard some material, some of the first songs that were done, I was blown away. And there was not a doubt in my mind that this was something I wanted to work on.
His vocals are so powerful, it's going to draw you to do something. As a genius musician, his voice commands you to get and do something.
You catch him right at his peak, right when he was at his prime, when his voice was so crisp and so full and so warm. You know, just listening to his tracks make you want to dance. You don't even have to see him. You just hear him, and you want to dance.
I think some of the fans have those same fears, and they wonder if we should be doing this. But you know what? The answer is yes, we should be doing it. If it wasn't supposed to be, it wouldn't be this good.
He influenced me since I was a kid.
I grew up when they were the Jackson Fives.
I remember being in Toledo, Ohio. I want to say it was like 1986 or something like that, me being like 9 years old and walking in the mall and hearing Human Nature and Thriller for the first time in the mall in Toledo, Ohio.
I mean, we're old enough to remember when Beat It and Thriller first came out. And, you know, we were 11 years old, so it made a huge impression on me just on a personal level, but then as I got a little older, on the musical level.
Michael might have been single-handedly the reason why I wanted to become a producer.
Were there any hesitations for anyone? I mean, you asked to look at everything in the vault, but you didn't know what was there, did you?
No, I had no idea what was there. So I had to have some guides. I made a rule for myself. I'm only interested in songs that Michael sang from top to bottom multiple times. Because then I would know that he loved the song. Because I didn't want us to put out music that Michael didn't want the world to hear. After my song selections, I thought about which producers really contemporize these songs, and I felt like the best producer was Timbaland.
If I would have did it, I wouldn't have had the piano in there. I would have had like bling, boom, bling, 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 bling. Put a, like a worm sound, a parliament worm. Like that print sound.
Right.
It'd be cool.
I don't know. There was just something I always loved about Timbaland's production.
always youthful, always funky, but they were still pop songs.
You have a powerful sound, and you're a powerful presence, musically a powerful presence, and you could have taken over, and the end result could have easily been that it sounded like a Timbaland album as opposed to a Michael Jackson album, because I feel you completely on these records, but...
I'm not overstepping my boundaries. I'm just enough in your face.
You let Michael still be the star of the show.
We've been planning how do we do this, and how would he want us to do this?
Right.
How would Michael want us to do this? We're not being flamboyant about the project. He has been with me through this whole process.
We should listen to Loving You...
The original.
And then let's listen to Loving You as you've contemporized it. Here's the original.
Hear the warp from the tape?
You hear that?
That's a dope sound, though. I like that.
Hello, August moon, where are the stars of the night? You promised me too soon, cause it's been cloudy all night.
Big difference, ain't it?
Oh my God. It's been cloudy all night, and the weather. Don't mind if I turn this up, dude. If you're not well, stay in bed. Cause I've been feeling down and blue, and it's cloudy in my head. Instead of going out to some restaurant, I stay home in bed. I'll be loving you. That's what I wanna do. But I noticed that what you did, you brought the pocket out and made his. It actually made his voice sound like...
Character.
I felt the energy in his, the way he was singing it.
That's the whole purpose, because that's what you loved about Michael.
When I went in there with the mindset of, what would Michael want me to do right now? There was things that I would do musically, and it was almost like I could hear his voice saying, no, try this.
I'm doing Michael Jackson, but I can't talk to him. So how do I channel to him? So when I did my music, I hear him saying, that's it, Tim. That's it, that's what I like. I look around, I'll be like, and nobody be in the room, I never shared this story. So I like, even with my co-producer, Jerome, he like, you all right? I said, no, I'm cool, man. His spirit resonated through me to give me the okay.
I was thinking every morning when we started opening up his vocal and we started listening back, I pretended like Michael was gonna come in the room in 10 minutes. And, you know, I wanted to make sure that I felt like he would have approved.
It was almost like his spirit was there with us when we did it.
This is another interesting one. This one is Blue Gangsta. You have no idea what this sounds like, right?
No. See, some of this stuff, after the first three songs I heard the original, I said, it's gonna throw me off, so just play the acapellas.
Like, sometimes when we ask producers or songwriters to go back and rewrite something, it's hard to do it because, like, what they heard when they wrote it is stuck.
This one don't sound as bad as the rest of them.
The beat is doing the right stuff.
It's cool, yeah. What you gonna do? You ain't a fan of mine.
Look what you put me through. Now that I'm the Blue Gangsta. It's the first time I've listened to that, except 9 months ago when I thought, okay, that's a melody that works. And I never listened again until Timbaland sent it back. And it sounded like this. What you gonna do? You ain't a friend of mine. Look what you put me through. Now that I'm the Blue Gangsta. What you gonna do? You ain't a friend of mine.
I don't never really talk. And you know me for years. I don't talk cocky, but.
No.
I'm a bad man.
Michael would be in the lounge watching footage on Jackie.